Azure Database for MariaDB is the newest open source database available on Azure. It's a fully managed service with built-in high availability, automatic backups, and scaling of resources that meet your needs. Andrea Lamb is here to give us an introduction and demo its use today on Azure Friday. Hello, this is Laura Rebelke, and today on Azure Friday, we have Andrea Lamb, a program manager with the Azure OSS Databases team, and she's here to talk to us about MariaDB. Hello, Andrea.
Hi, Laura. How are you today?
I'm doing great.
Awesome.
Doing great. So, what are you going to talk about today?
So today I'm here to talk about the Azure Database for MariaDB service. We brought this up into GA in December of 2018. So I'm here to talk about some of the different things that you can do with the managed service and walk through a demo using WordPress with a template that was developed by our partners at Benami.
Fantastic. That sounds like a pretty exciting demo.
Yeah.
So talk to me about why MariaDB?
So we chose MariaDB as the next database to bring into our OSS Databases platform. Today we have MySQL, Postgres, and we now have MariaDB. And MariaDB was more of a strategic choice. We realized that there's a lot to do at Microsoft with embracing the open source community. So we wanted to make sure that we kind of brought ourselves into the conversation with the open source community. We even joined the MariaDB Foundation as a platinum sponsor. So really trying to help drive the community and the conversations about what it is to kind of develop against MariaDB. And we've also tried to push some of our improvements into the MariaDB community engine, as well as some of the drivers and tools that you can use with MariaDB.
That's fantastic. So yeah. We are actively contributing to the open source.
Yes.
MariaDB.
Yeah, and it's been a really awesome journey. We've gotten a lot of really great feedback so far from the community, and it's definitely a work in progress. We're definitely trying to, you know, do the best that we can to communicate and work with developers in the community and really try to give back.
Great. Yeah. Well, what would you like to show us?
So today I'm here just to show you a demo on the actual MariaDB service. Essentially, we have partnered with Bitnami. Bitnami has a great open source community of their own. They definitely have the mindshare in the community. And it's kind of the thing that we realized is we wanted to make sure we partnered with folks like Bitnami to ensure that, you know, it's not just Microsoft pushing out images and stuff into the Azure marketplace. We wanted to make sure that we gave everybody a slice of the pie, if you will.
Great.
And so with the MariaDB service, you know, as a managed database service, we want to offer stuff like high availability, automated security, patching, backups, and all that kind of good stuff. So in the demo today, I'm going to show you how to provision a WordPress blogging website with Azure Database for MariaDB as the backend store.
Okay.
All right, so let's switch over. I'm going to go into the Azure Marketplace. So today, Bitnami has two images available. The first is WordPress, so WordPress being one of the most popular blogging or CMS systems available, very popular in the open source community. MariaDB is one of the nice drop-in replacements for MySQL to be used as a database. Bitnami has also released the Drupal image. And the Drupal image, again, also a very popular open source CMS. But today I'm going to focus on WordPress. And what I've done is I've taken this existing WordPress template that they've released with us, and I have pre-baked it. So from the Azure portal, what you would do is you would go into create a resource, and you could actually go search up WordPress Bitnami. And what you'll find is the existing WordPress with Azure Database for MariaDB template. And what I've done is I've gone ahead and pre-provisioned this ahead of time. So once you click through all the steps, what you'll find is in a resource group that you've created, you'll find an Azure Database for MariaDB server already provisioned. As well as a VM that hosts the actual WordPress application itself, along with some of the IP resources, et cetera, et cetera. So there's also a storage account associated with it. So as part of this, what I wanted to show you is how easy it is to just, with a few clicks, be able to provision a WordPress application along with the MariaDB server. And so once you have this up and running, what does it look like? So if I quickly switch over and I go into the front end and actually navigate to the front end, which is hosted on a virtual machine, you'll see here that this is the DNS name available. Have it open in this tab. And you'll see this is a generic WordPress site. I haven't done anything special to it. This is what you can get in the open source community today. And you'll see it starts you off with a Hello World screen. And then from there, it's really up to you to start writing your first post, spread the words of what you wanna put out into the internet. So I'm gonna log in here as the main user, and I'll have that open in a second tab. And essentially, this is the main dashboard that you can use to manage your WordPress website. So I kind of wanted to show you, okay, that's great, I have a WordPress here. What does that mean for the database? Where does the data go? So I'm going to create my very first post. And let's go ahead and we'll start typing something. So let's call this Azure Friday. And I'm going to say, it's great to be here. And let's go ahead and publish that. We'll publish that immediately. And from here, I can actually go view the post. What does it actually look like on my website? And you can see here, Azure Friday, it's great to be here. So awesome, it's now in the WordPress site. But how do we actually know that it's made it to the backend database? So I'm going to open MySQL Workbench, which can be used to actually query both MySQL and MariaDB engines. And I've already connected to it. And let's go ahead and take a look at the WordPress posts table. This is where all of the blog posts will get pushed into and managed.
Okay.
So as you can see here, there's no existing blog that I had just written. So let's go ahead and rerun the query. And you can see here that there's a new post that was created, Azure Friday, it's great to be here. So mainly I just kind of want to show how easy it is just to get your very first blog post up and running, how to integrate with the Azure database for MariaDB service without having to do anything extra.
Right.
You don't have to go do a second deployment, and all that is kind of, enveloped in a one-stop shop. And
great.
That's what's really awesome about the service and working with partners.
Great. Now, why would we want to take advantage of the service versus maybe just running it in a VM or on our own?
So as part of the managed service, like I mentioned, you get all of the automatic patching, the backups are all taken for you. We also push any of the security patches that say there's a security bug fix. You don't have to go manage that by yourself.
Great. So as a developer, it's just super easy for me.
And also I wanted to highlight that with the MariaDB service, you can scale your compute and your storage resources as you need. So let's say, during the peak time of a business day, you want to make sure that you have as much compute allocated to that server as possible, and then spin that back down during off-peak business hours.
Right.
Helping with, the ability to scale automatically and elastically as you need.
That sounds like a great option for me. That's a great option. What more can we expect from your contributions with MariaDB?
So we're definitely, in terms of the service, we're working on bringing more and more features. For example, one of the new features we just brought up was the VNet service endpoints. So this allows you to connect from a virtual network to your Azure database from your MariaDB server. And we're constantly working on new improvements to kind of get it to the same point as we have for the MySQL and Postgres database services.
That's great.
Yeah.
And where can we go learn more?
So you can check out aka.ms/MariaDB. From there, that's our service landing page. You can go learn about what's available, pricing, go read up on documentation. Mm-hmm. We also have a user voice forum that we've been looking at and tracking to help get feedback from our customers to learn about what to prioritize next in terms of different types of features that they're looking for, whether it's to beef up different types of different parts of the service, and to bring up any new improvements that they'd like to see in the service.
Great. Well, thank you so much. Is there anything more?
Follow us on Twitter. We have
our
Twitter account is AzureDB, MariaDB. So use that to learn about new announcements, new features that are coming up. And also check out the documentation. If you guys have any questions, you can also reach out to us over Twitter. That's basically it.
Fantastic. Thanks again, Andrea. It was great to see you again.
Great to see you as well.
We are learning all about Azure Database for MariaDB today on Azure Friday.